Hello everyone, let us start with the discussion of question answers from chapter 7 story 1, that is A Baker from Goa. I hope you all have enjoyed listening and reading to the story about the bakers from Goa. Yet for your quick revision, the summary part has been given here once again so that you can go ahead with the summary part and get to know to revise the notes so that when we discuss question answers, they become very easy for you people. So I am not going to go ahead by reading all these things again and again. This is for your knowledge and your revision. Please go ahead with all these things before we start with the discussion of question answers. So let us start with the discussion of question answers. Let's discuss thinking about text. Which of these statements are correct? The painter was an important person in the village in old time. Answers have been given to you just beneath it. So the first answer is correct. Painters still exist in Goan villages. Again correct. The painters went away with the Portuguese. Incorrect. They are still living in Goa. The painters continue to wear a single piece long frock. Incorrect, because now they wear pants and shirts. Bread and cakes were an integral part of Goan life in old days. It is correct. Traditional bread baking is still a very profitable business. Correct. Painters and their families starve in the present times. Incorrect. They never starved and they never would starve. Question number two is bread an important part of Goan life? How do you know this? Yes, bread is an important part of Goan life. It is needed for marriage gifts, parties and feasts. Bread is also needed by a mother for preparing sandwiches during her daughter's engagement. Thus, it is necessary to have breads for every occasion, because of which the presence of a baker's furnace in the village, please read it as village, is very important. Question 3. Tick the right answer. What is the tone of the author when he says the following? You have to identify these words. The thud and the jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo can still be heard in some places. Is this nostalgic? Is it hopeful? Is it sad? Nostalgic is when we are reminded of some past events or past happenings. So I hope you can understand what the tone is. It is nostalgic. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. Is it nostalgic or hopeful? It is again nostalgic. Now, I have given you certain questions here from the part which have been given in between the chapter, talk about the text. So, let's discuss these questions. They are going to help you in preparing your chapter further. What are the elders in Goa nostalgic about? The elders in Goa are nostalgic about the good old Portuguese days and their love of bread and loaves. The writer says that the eaters of loaves have left, but makers still exist. Is bread making still popular in Goa? How do you know? Yes, bread making is still popular in Goa. This is very clear from the narrator's statement that the eaters have gone away, leaving the makers behind. There are mixers, moulders, and one who bake the loaves. The time-tested furnaces still exist there. Question number 3. What is the baker called? We know the answer. The baker is called a painter in Goa. When would the baker come every day? Why did the children run to meet him? The baker would come twice a day, once early in the morning and the second time when he returned after selling his stuff. The children would run to meet him as they wanted to have bread bangles. Again, certain questions from talk about the text. Match the following. What is a must as marriage gift? Cakes or bolinas? You should know this. So as marriage gift, it is sweet bread called bolinas. For a party or a feast? For a daughter's engagement and for Christmas? So the answers are here. As marriage gift, sweet bread called ball. For a party or a feast, bread. For a daughter's engagement, sandwiches. And for Christmas, cakes and bolinas. Another question, what did the baker wear first in the Portuguese days? So answer is, the bakers were usually dressed up in a peculiar dress called cabaye. It was a single piece long frock reaching down to the knees. Second question is, when the author was young, so what did the bakers wear? During his childhood days, the author saw the bakers wearing a shirt and trousers which were shorter than full length ones and longer than half pants. Question 3. Who invites the comment, he is dressed like a peder? Why? Any person who is wearing a half pant which reaches just below the knees invites this comment. This is because the baker known as peder used to dress like that. Where were the monthly accounts of the baker recorded? Monthly accounts of the baker were recorded on some wall in the house with a pencil. What does a jackfruit-like appearance mean? This is given in the chapter that they generally had a jackfruit-like appearance. So it means having a plump physique like a jackfruit. So here we reach to the end of our presentation. And the first story is over with the discussion of question answers.